You think it's funny to laugh, but I'm a brother to math. There ain't no way kicking bass on the dope drum track. All I do is the cool, kick it cool, still the floor. Your body's taking a sip and the levels are full. So get ready for my ritual, the dad's peak. Pumps bow down, let the lyricist speak. And you just get slayed, the wife gets paid. The girl in the jacket as it is got laid. I'm the rest you will let, keep the record the rest. I'm in the bed, I understand, I'm into what you expect.
Likes it, baby.
Yeah.
tonight. I like it.
Yo, man,
everybody in Miami tonight is gonna be on my new album called Ice Capades. We're recording live tonight. You are on the album. Thank you. What's up, buddy? Everybody's been doing their part, and everybody in the house has been getting busy tonight. Yeah! And we're doing a longer show than we've ever done before, ever. Yeah? Just for Miami. Because I'm not ready to go home yet. Are y'all ready to go home? I don't really think so. I'm serious, man. This has got to be the longest show we've ever done. It has to be. I'm going to tour. Check it. But you know what I feel like doing now?
What could you possibly feel like doing now, buddy?
Playing some funky music.
Thank you. We're here with Slipknot.
What's up?
For Grindr Magazine in Chile.
Shades.
Okay. And
on what? Corey?
Go ahead. I'm Jen, cast assistant.
Lock the door there, then. Don't let anybody in.
Questioning Slipknot. First of all, we noticed in your bio it said that you went through some lineup changes in the early days. How long did it take you to settle on the current lineup and who initially started the band?
Sean and the bass player, Paul, initially started the band. I came and checked them out. When they initially accepted me into the band, I had some ideas that I brought into the people I wanted to add. Just recently, like a few months ago, we just replaced another guitar player. So it's been such an evolution on creating this monster that we've had that it's taken a long time to actually, you know, get everyone set in stone because there's 9 guys. The fact is that, you know, some people, even though they're our bros, didn't want to deal with the touring. Since we've all known each other like 10 years prior to even starting the band, it's been really easy to pick who we wanted in the band and whatnot. It's been really easy. We've never had any problems.
Okay. And who came up with the name and what does it mean to you?
Naming the band, I came up with the name for the band, and basically we don't look at Slipknot as the, you know, what a definition of one is. We look at it as that's what our music is, that's the moniker that we have. I mean, it's a short word, it's easy, it sounds cool, it's 2 syllables, we got a logo that's pretty defined. All we want it to be is like whatever you take out of it, we want to have a moniker that's really easy for people to remember, so when they hear the band and they see them, and when they see the band and they hear the music, that's easily recognizable as one thing is Slipknot.
Okay. And being from Iowa, were you able to play many gigs before actually getting signed?
Yeah, we played our asses off for as long as we could. Played the Midwest, and because of funds, unfortunately, we couldn't get all the way to the East Coast or the West Coast, so we maintained strong in our home Midwest area. As many shows as we could do, and we created a really big following, you know, especially, you know, locally and, you know, the tri-state area.
Okay, so you have...
I'm sorry, go ahead.